Hi everyone, welcome back to another Brick Veteran Kit Overview. I'm your host. Today we're going to talk about the A-10C Warthog. So this is one of the most iconic aircraft that there's probably ever been in the American arsenal, just because it's a gun, or a plane built around a gun. And that's the 30mm Gatling gun here in the nose. So I'll just start off going over features right there, because this is a 3D printed metal Gatling gun part, and I don't need to say anything else. That's pretty much the kit. But right on top of that, we've got awesome prints done by Brick designers, the iconic shark mouth print all the way wrapping around the nose. That's one feature. I always start nose when I build and build back from there. So that's one feature I had to get right, because I had to make sure it was ultra printable, and I think it turned out pretty well building wise. Just using the least amount of pieces possible and making a nice canvas for those prints to make a nice transition wrap around all the way around on the nose. And the prints just keep going right from there all the way back. There's a refueling port on top of the nose. There's a nice printed part on that windscreen and the HUD right behind it inside the cockpit. Pretty much all I'm going to talk about on this kit is printed parts, because that's all it is printed parts. It's a canvas for Brick designers to do his magic. Nice cockpit, fits a minifigure, and it ended up being a really clean build with the spine tapering back and making a nice transition around with the panels to hide that gap. Just really cleaned up the model and kind of made it a lot easier to build from there once I was able to accomplish that technique of how that clips into the top and it just falls all the way back, and that's most of the shaping right there. Most of the shaping difficulty was that spine. Then the engines attach onto that part of the spine and they are tilted back a little bit, and that's just like the real plane. Thankfully, Lego's come out with some new pieces over the years, so I'm able to build engines using nice empty half cylinders, because the weight of the plane, it's really nose heavy in real life because of that huge gun in the front. And building it in Lego, if the landing gear's right in the middle of the midpoint and it's a tricycle landing gear, it wants to be really tail heavy. So having hollow cylinders, and it also makes a really nice printable surface too. The other versions have printed parts in there. We have some add-on packs for this as well, which is just printed parts that you can add on to the kit. So there are some with printed parts there. The intakes, the blades are printed, and attaching these engines was a difficult part. Since I'm using these cylinders, they're consistent all the way around. There's no attachment points. So I had to come up with a way to attach them past that point where the exhaust is. So I was able to accomplish that, and it makes it a really sturdy, clean connection. It's actually one of my favorite parts of the build, is building the engines and clipping them into place. Really satisfying. From there, it's all flaps. I got flaps everywhere on both sides of the wings, as well as the ailerons, and when they split out like this underneath the wing for dive brakes. And then on the tail, there's the rudders, which was a really fun technique, just using the 1x2 hinge top clipped in on the vertical stabilizers. And then the elevators here on the tail. This was a really fun kit to design all those working features, because it's, other than just being a good printed part canvas, it's a really good canvas for just adding all the functioning things, because it's very simple lines on the wings and on the tail features. So it's always fun when I can incorporate that stuff. I can't always incorporate it. So this one, I just went wild with all the moving features. So landing gear retracts, same on both sides, very simple, very sturdy. It's got a pretty cool loadout. Again, just more printed parts, bombs underneath, missiles, sensors, and the stand is very similar, if not the exact same, as other Brick Veteran stands that we've made, in which it can sit horizontal like this, flying just at a nice straight line, or you can tilt it down like it's going in for a gun run. Outside of that, this kit comes with a full 360 printed minifigure with printing in between the legs. I think that about wraps up all the details I really wanted to stress and go over on the A-10 Warthog. Be sure to follow us on Instagram and check out brickveteran.com for more information. Thank you.